It has reached thousands of people and is causing a revolution in their lives. Real people. Extraordinary miracles. Stay tuned. The movement of faith that is spreading in America is now on the air. You are watching Showdown of Faith with your host, Vera Fonseca.
There is a solution for you. There is a way out to this problem of yours. You are not going to die. They said you are going to die in this situation, sick. They said you are going to die in prison. They have told you this is the end of your family. Your son will never come out of jail. But I am here today to tell you that Jesus is the consuming fire. And once the fire of Jesus Christ enters one's body, one's life, the life of this person is never the same. And today we are going to pray that the fire of God may enter your life. Jesus is the consuming fire to consume this drug addiction, to consume this cancer, this fibroid, to consume all your debts. He is a consuming fire. In this faith, in this spirit, we are beginning a new day. Do not look down, because when you look down, you see problems. But when you raise your head, you look up to Jesus, you see the solution.
Give us a call. 1-888-332-4141.
Our helpline is open right now, and the counselors are there waiting for you to give us a call. The number is 1-888-332-4141. As you can see on your screen, they are already there. Once I have your name and your prayer request, I will place it inside of the holy oil. And before the end of the show, before it comes to an end, Bishop Bira will be praying for God to consume all the problems that has been plaguing your life. That number again is 1-888-332-4141.
You are watching Showdown of Faith with Bishop Bira Fonseca.
We are just beginning the new month, the second day of August. And I'm praying that from the 1st, as we prayed yesterday, until here, the 31st, that God may bless every single day of your month, that you may be successful. Today, you are going to see the story of Miss Yolanda, a lady who was abused, raped, and found herself doing drugs. She even tried through many churches, many ways to ease her pain. But the solution is not in the building. The solution comes from God, from the Lord, and He is the solution for you. I bring to you now more testimonies, results of faith, people that have been praying in this ministry and their lives have changed.
The following people all suffered from the same problem, chronic pain.
Miss Julia, what happened to you? I see that you have some braces, you have things. What was happening to you?
Well, I had, my ankle was bothering me, and the foot doctor gave me this to wear. Mm-hmm. And I don't have that pain in my ankle anymore. And
how long were you having problems on your legs?
Oh gosh, it's a year for my knee.
1 year?
On the left knee.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And you had to wear braces?
I had to wear the brace for my ankle.
For your ankle?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
But the pain is gone. I don't have to wear that anymore.
What did you do for the pain to be gone?
The doctor, I couldn't take the medicine they gave me because it hurt my stomach.
Uh-huh.
So I would pray over myself. So the swelling went down, the swelling is gone, the pain is gone, praise God. And my knee, I had pain in my knee for a year. And the doctor took x-ray and he said that the bone was getting ready, you know, get together and, you know, rub against together. And so he wanted to give me a shot and I didn't want the shot. So I prayed over myself. So he told me I had to, the lidocaine. I had to put the lidocaine patches.
So it was a patch?
Yes, on my knee. And then I had to wear this.
To wear that?
Yes.
For a year you were wearing that?
Yes.
And then after, did you use the water?
Not until I came here and I used the water and I was here last week and you prayed with the cross and I can walk down and my knee did not hurt.
Your knee doesn't hurt no more?
No, sir.
Move your knees there.
My knees do not hurt and I just give God glory and praise and my faith.
When I called here those who were in pain, where was the pain?
In my heart.
In your heart?
Yes.
How long was this pain? There was it? Palpitation?
A couple of days. And as you were saying, put your hands up where your pain is. It's gone.
It's gone?
It's gone.
Disappeared?
Yes, disappeared.
She received a miracle now.
Miss Diane, how long have you been coming here to the church?
First time.
Your first time. Okay. What was your problem when you came here?
I had pain, severe pain on my left side.
For how long?
2003.
Since 2003. So we're talking about 15 years. Mm-hmm. What happened for you to have this pain? What caused this pain?
Surgery, I don't know what. I had nerves pinching, but it turns out maybe I had my back never fused from birth. I think that was one of the diagnoses. So I had a fusion and they put screws in. And 6 months later, the screw came out on the left side. So I had to have that same back surgery all over again. And from that, it left a lot of pain on this left side. And so.
And now after the strong prayer, did you drink the water, by the way, the blessed water?
I did.
So tell us, how are you doing now?
I'm doing fine. I feel good.
Where's the pain?
I don't know. I want to go stay wherever it is.
You could not do it for 15 years.
Right.
And all the pain was there.
Yes.
No pain.
No pain.
Amen. God bless you.
You are watching Showdown of Faith with Bishop Vera Fonseca.
I have Jalissa here on the line who needs a spiritual advice. Miss Jalissa, good day to you. What is going on right now in your life, ma'am?
Arguments in the family with my daughter and her and my son-in-law and disrespectfulness and my health.
So arguments in the family, arguments between you and your children or between each other or what?
My child, it's my only daughter.
Your only daughter. So you and her, you argue, you fight a lot?
She's disrespectful.
She's disrespectful. Okay, I got it. Ma'am, look, I need you to listen to something because it applies directly to what you're going through. And I'm going to speak to you in just a moment. Don't go anywhere. Just pay attention to this, please.
Family, the base of every society, every country, every city. It is with our family we learn how to cope with problems effectively or ineffectively. We search for emotional support. And we quickly learn behavioral patterns that shapes our individuality. Constant arguments, fights, is one of the many behavioral patterns that develop due to the lack of trust, pride, and insecurities.
You don't tell me anything!
You're not the man that I married.
Time and time again, you became physically abusive.
Well, is that what you call? Tell me, because I get sick and tired of this!
To avoid further arguments, you bury your pain. It's been years since you've been hurt, but you just can't forgive. To find relief, you've turned to drugs. There is no peace in this home. The holidays are the only days you get along. But when you are in public, together, you pretend as if all is well.
Miss Jalissa.
Yes?
Can you relate to that, to what you heard there?
Yes.
Is that what's happening? Arguments, constant fights, butting heads, etc.
Yes.
Ma'am, it's because there's a spirit there trying to destroy your family. It knows if it can make you stressed out with you and your daughter, then it can break you down inside. And so this evil wants to destroy from the inside out. Right now, I want to show you a testimony because there's someone who went through similar things to you. And after that, we're going to bless your family. And the situation is going to change. Don't hang up. Please pay attention to this.
My son actually was hanging around with the wrong crowd, got himself into trouble. He was very rebellious. He was almost sent to jail. That was since in 2013, and we keep going to court, and you know, they keep putting up the case and putting off the case over and over. And the case was supposed to go to trial. If the case did go to trial, he was looking at a sentence of at least 5 to 8 years. I mean, I started off coming to the church in 2011, but then 2012, I made a decision, you know, to really give my life to Christ. I have seen many results in my life since I've turned my life over to Christ. I have seen my son get out of this trial. He's free now. I am a happy mother.
Miss Julissa, let me ask a question. What is your daughter's name?
Tatiana Fernando.
Tatiana. Look, we're going to place your name and Tatiana's name inside the oil in just a moment. And before the end of the program, when the bishop makes the prayer, he's going to be praying for them as well. And Miss Julissa, things are going to start to change in your family. Right now, I bless you. I bless your daughter. And I determine things are going to move. Keep your head up. Stay strong, because soon we're going to have the testimony of you and your family's life changing. Okay?
Okay.
God bless you, ma'am. Have a wonderful day. And all the rest of you, if you're struggling with family problems, call us at 1-888-332-4141.
Give us a call. 1-888-332-4141.
We're going to go there to New York. Bishop Flavio has a testimony. Someone that suffered with depression. Good day, Bishop.
Good day, Pastor Damian. Miss Atma, how bad was this depression for you?
I had sleepless nights, anxiety attack, panic attack, very nervous, very tense, confused sometimes, sometimes very angry. And most of the times, I cannot sleep in the night.
Not even taking pills. How was that?
The doctor prescribed some medication for me. I took it, but he gave me a warning and told me that if I take it constantly, I could get addicted to it. So to take it frequently. However, when I get up in the morning, I have the same problem.
So
can I ask you a question, ma'am? You talked about panic attacks. How were these panic attacks? What would happen?
I would be very fearful. Very fearful. Like when I go to the subway, I feel like I can run. I feel like I can stand up. I feel like very nervous, like trembling.
Okay.
Like my head hurts, my heart hurts.
So it would affect you even physically?
Yes.
Okay.
And mentally.
Okay, you can continue with your story. Go ahead.
Mm-hmm. And then my husband and I, we sat down one night and we showed us, and we saw Bishop Bira at the Showdown of Faith. And we called the number on Fulton Street, the church, and we came to the church. And we came to the church and the bishop prayed for us and told us
But church was not the solution.
No.
Because she told me, Pastor Damian, for over 15 years, she had been many churches. Church was not the solution.
Church was not the solution. And for many years, I've been going to church, me and my children,
But continue to suffer of depression, panic attacks, sleepless nights.
Was the same. It never changed.
But by coming to the Universal Church after watching the show on BET, the showdown of faith.
Yes.
So what you did in the church, and how is your life today?
the bishop prayed for us, myself and my husband. And the same night he prayed for us, that was a Friday night for deliverance, I can say that I was healed, because I came back Sunday morning and I told him that we are healed. We slept from Saturday night until now. We are now healed and we are now free.
No more sleepless nights.
No more sleepless nights.
No more panic attacks.
No more panic attacks and no more medication.
No need of medication.
No more need of medication.
So things change completely.
Things has changed. And since that was about 1 year ago, we have made chains of prayer. We are here every Friday night. We never miss a Friday night for deliverance. We are here on Sunday. Every Sunday for the blessed water. The water has also helped us with the bishop's advice and obedience. We are here every
That is great.
Friday and
Ma'am,
Sunday.
That is great, because there's many people suffering with these spiritual problems and they think that they're crazy. They think that they're out of their mind and they don't want to seek help. Bishop Flavio, where can they find you if they need help with these spiritual problems?
She knows.
1091 Fulton Street, Brooklyn, New York.
Thank you very much, Pastor Daniel.
Great. Thank you, Bishop. Thank you, ma'am. Your story is great. It's going to help many people. And for all of you that are going through similar spiritual attacks, depression, spiritual problems, panic attacks, there is help. This is proof that there is help. 1-888-332-4141 is the number to call if you need this kind of help.
Slavery. According to the dictionary, a word that signifies servitude, lack of freedom, submission to a dominating influence. In previous times, slaves were dominated by the use of brutal force. They were subordinated and lived in miserable conditions without any consideration. They were prisoners of a situation that did not seem to have an end. Now, stop and think. Nowadays, in our society, what can dominate a human being? Can you imagine what it could be? If you answered alcohol or drugs, you got it right. According to research, there are 7 million addicts in the USA. Chemical dependency enslaves the mind of a person, making them commit senseless acts and later suffer severe consequences. Observe this video. Those who smoke have become submissive to the addiction. This is a case of thousands of people who left their homes to live in the streets. The reality is dehumanizing. It is as if the era of slavery came back, and instead of people doing the torture, it is done by the drugs.
If you do a research, if you go back in time, you are going to see that your ancestors, they were slaves. If you do a research, you are going to find that four generations behind, five generations behind, I'm talking about the great-great-grandparents, they were slaves. They were bound by chains. They did not have merit. They did not have freedom to take care of their children. Their children could not have education. As many struggle to pay for their children's education. Many of them were sick and have no access to medications, doctors. That were the past of your ancestors. Nowadays, you are free. I mean, you do not have the chains on your neck, around your body, like the prisoners in jail. But many who are in jail because the family members were there one day as well. We are praying to break the ancestral curses, because there are many curses that come from one to another, and now in this present generation. I show to you now the case of Miss Yolanda. She was living in this curse, ancestral curse. The curse was broken from her life.
Stop everything, because this is no fairy tale. Yesterday, Yolan told you about her life as a pastor's wife.
We would go out, feed the homeless. He would minister to the homeless. He would always seem to have the right words to say, but he was living a double life.
The pastor was an alcoholic, a drug user. He committed adultery many times throughout her 9 years of marriage.
He committed adultery. I found pictures, text messages. There were phone calls.
It was impossible to be happy. Right now, Yolan will tell you about the generational curses in her family and how she tried to commit suicide. This is No Fairy Tale.
Curse was just following me everywhere I went. No matter how much I tried to do right, wrong still followed me, which was a generational curse because it was passed down from generations. My great-grandfather, he was an alcoholic. My mother was an alcoholic. I started to become an alcoholic. It's just a generational curse that was passed down. Worst part of my life is when I hit rock bottom as an adult. When you don't have nobody to help you, you don't have nobody there to talk to you. You don't have nobody there to guide you. I remember praying and seeking God and asking, why, where are you? And it was like God wasn't listening, is what I thought. I thought God had forgot about me, but it was more me, I had forgot about God. So I remember sitting on the bed one day and I was like, repeating the cycle, generational curse of the same type of men. And I wanted to end my life. I remember pouring a cup of Clorox and I was about to drink it. And as I was about to drink it, someone knocked it out of my hand. But I had came to the point in my life that it was the lowest part of my life. I just wanted to end my life. I just wanted to go to sleep and never wake up. I was about to be homeless. I could barely afford to feed myself, let alone do anything for my children if they needed help. It's sad to see and sad to talk about and think about when your life is like come to an end, you think, and you don't have no way to, you know, you don't have nobody to help you. You don't have nobody to guide you. It's hard to talk about it and think about it. I try to block it out because it's so painful. It's so painful to think about how bad my life was. I would find myself going to the pastors or the preachers at the churches that I belong to, but they looked down on me and shamed, like they were ashamed of me or I was an outcast. So I didn't have that guidance from them. It's hard when you went searching for love and the love that you thought you found was the wrong love because they truly didn't love you. They were there to use you, abuse you. Mentally, physically, spiritually. It's like piercing, like if someone just cuts you and just study pour alcohol on the wound. And every time they pour it on there, it opens up. That's how I felt inside because I was looking for love and I couldn't find it. I couldn't find it.
Tomorrow, Yolan will tell you how she overcame depression and broke the generational curses that were upon her.
Generational curse has been broken. I feel good about myself. I'm happy. I have so much to live for.
Tomorrow. This is No Fairy Tale. Watch this show until the end so that the consuming fire of Jesus may enter your life.
We have been praying every single day for some years here on the Shodown of Faith. But now this time, we are going to pray based on the name of Jesus Christ. In a few, you are going to place your hand upon His precious name. There is no name greater than the name of Jesus Christ. Actually, as you are looking at His name now, this fire goes inside of you. Yes, the heat of the power, the fire of God goes inside of you to consume every curse, every disease, depression, temptation. In a few, you are going to place your hand here and we are going to pray together. Nobody has more names to be placed inside of the holy oil.
Yes, Bishop, we have Dominic. He is calling from Mississippi, who suffers with drug addiction as well as anger problem, and he wants to overcome it. Dominic, your name is inside of the holy oil. We have Sasha, who is calling us from Kansas. She is asking prayer for her family. Also, she is asking for a financial breakthrough. And we also have Rebecca. She is calling us from Alabama. Rebecca's asking for peace and unity in the family. She also wants to find a better job to provide for her children. Rebecca, your name is also inside of the holy oil. I also have names, people who have been writing to Bishop Bira asking for prayer. We have Travis, who is in need of healing. He is asking for total healing in his life. We have Mrs. Rena. She is asking prayer for her family. Jordan, who is asking prayer for a financial breakthrough in his life, and many more people who are writing to Bishop Bira. Right now, we have Pastor Damien with a live call of someone who is in need of spiritual counseling. Pastor Damien.
We have Lester on the line. Lester, what's going on? What's happening in your life right now?
I have stomach bloating, stomach tightness on the left side of my stomach, and I need the Lord to heal it.
Okay, how long is this bloating, this tightness been happening?
Ever since April of this year.
Since April. Did you get in an accident? Did something happen? Or it just came out of nowhere?
It happened right after I ate a sausage biscuit for breakfast.
So you just ate a breakfast and after that this happened and it's been going on now for a couple of months already?
Yes.
Okay, have you been to doctors? What are they saying?
Oh, I ain't been to the doctor yet.
You haven't been to the doctor, but you don't know what's going on in your body?
No.
Okay.
But I know the Lord can fix it today.
Absolutely. And I'm glad you have faith in that because you are right. Lester, listen, when you don't understand what's going on, it's something strange happening. Many times it's because that's something that is spiritual. I'm sure that you ate the same kind of thing for breakfast many times, but this time you ate and this bloating started and it's been going on now for months. Lester, God is going to heal you. He's going to heal you from this. Let me show you what's going on in your life right now, and we are going to determine your healing.
Undiagnosable diseases. Hospitals, doctors, nurses, and medication have all improved our quality of life. They're a vital part of a healthy existence. Yet there are illnesses that confound doctors, illnesses that resist all forms of treatment. Illnesses that are unexplainably aggressive, surgeries that are unable to bring the expected relief. Invisible to a doctor's eyes or to the most advanced medical procedures, evil spirits cause torment through pain and sickness. Undiagnosable diseases are a sign of the presence of evil spirits.
You see, Lester, sometimes these things can be caused by evil forces, a spirit attacking your health. God is going to set you free. I know you believe in that, and it's going to happen. What I want you to do right now is stay there on the line because I'm going to have one of my team talk to you. We are going to determine your freedom, Lester, and you're going to call us back letting us know that this stopped and that it never came back. Do you believe? Great. Don't go anywhere. Just stay on the line. I have someone that's going to speak to you now. If you're going through similar problems, something came upon you all of a sudden, unexpected. You were eating breakfast. You were doing one thing, and then all of a sudden it hit you. There's something spiritually attacking you. You need deliverance. Call us now at 1-888-691-2291.
We are reaching now the moment of prayer, the moment where we are going to touch the name of Jesus. But before the prayer, let me talk about the 21 day fast of Daniel on Mount Hermon. The fasting is going to begin August the 6th and we go until August 26th. This kind of fasting is not about food or drinking, but a spiritual detox. Our Lord Jesus, he was on earth serving the Lord. But before his ministry, he went to the wilderness. He was baptized in water, and the Spirit took him to be alone by himself in the wilderness. But there, he was able to overcome the devil because he was fasting. I know his fast was for food. He was not eating for 40 days and 40 nights. However, I am talking about the spiritual fasting. What is a spiritual fast? It's when you separate yourself from the world to be by God. You and God are every single day. On the 6th, that is going to be next Monday, every day, here in the showdown of faith, we are going to seek the Holy Spirit. He is going to fill your soul, fill your heart. Right now is the moment of the prayer. You are going to pray the Lord's Prayer and touch the name of Jesus.
After this manner, therefore, pray ye. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
Touch now the name of Jesus. As you place your hand on the screen, you are now touching his name. And wherever you are, whoever you may be, receive power now. Receive the power of Jesus inside of your body. His power enters you from the top of your head down to your feet. And his power consumes now all diseases, all infirmity. His power delivers you from all kinds of evil. This tumor disappears right now. This inflammation, bleeding problem, stop right now. The fire of God enters your body and he restore your body. You had a stroke. My Lord, there is this person that had a stroke. There is this person that used to be healthy. Now she's in a wheelchair. This person cannot even go to the bathroom himself, herself. Right now, oh, consume fire. Enter this body and clean out. Remove now every disease, every infirmity. In the name of Jesus Christ, be free, be healthy, be clean. The Lord Jesus cleans your body once and for all. And if you believe, you say, amen. Breathe now in and out. Amen. Just believe the power of God, the heat of God's power has entered your life and the Lord has made you free. You are free. Fear nothing, fear no one, because you are free. If you want to see me, this is my physical address. 5313 Martin Luther King Boulevard. The church is just 5 minutes away from downtown Houston. Tomorrow again, I'll be back here with one more showdown of faith. God bless you. Have a good one.
Thank you for watching the Showdown of Faith.